We are going to discuss about share forfeiture and partial reissue of the shares. If you have not watched the first video, please look at the description to find the link for the same and watch the video. After watching the first video, if you watch this video, you will gain better understanding over the share forfeiture and reissue. This is a small introduction about me. And this is about my area of specialization in teaching and research. Let's have a look at the problem. A company forfeits 100 shares of 10 rupees each, originally issued at a premium of 2 rupees per share. The shareholder paid 4 rupees per share on application but did not pay allotment money of 4 rupees per share, which includes premium, and call money of 4 rupees per share. Only 50 of the forfeited shares were subsequently reissued at rupees 8 per share as fully paid up. Past journal entries for forfeiture and reissue of the forfeited shares. Let me quickly sum up the problem. The shareholder to whom 100 shares were allotted asked to pay 4 rupees on application, 4 rupees on allotment, which includes 2 rupees securities premium, and finally 4 rupees on the call. So 4 plus 4 plus 4 comes to 12 rupees, which is the issue price per share. Whereas par value per share is only 10 rupees. So par value 10 plus securities premium 2, it comes to 12 rupees. That is the issue price per share. On his failure to pay the allotment and call money, his shares were forfeited. Out of the 100 shares forfeited, 50 shares were reissued by the company at 8 rupees per share as fully paid up. Therefore, the company has incurred a loss of 2 rupees per share on the reissue. How I say 2 rupees is a loss on reissue per share? Par value of the share is 10 rupees. Issue price is only 8 rupees. So 10 minus 8, it comes to 2 rupees, which is a loss per share. Don't take the issue price per share, the original issue price per share, 12 rupees for this calculation, the calculation of a loss on reissue per share. You always consider only the par value of the share, irrespective of the situation where you find issue of shares at premium or discount or at par. You always take par value per share and do the calculation of a loss on reissue per share. Now let's have a look at the journal entry for forfeiture of the share. I told you in the forfeiture journal entry, what is going to be debited? The called up value per share till the date of forfeiture will be debited with share capital account. If securities premium asked for is not paid by the shareholder at default, it has to be reversed and that will also be debited separately. Look at it. Share capital account debtor 100 into 10. They have not put 12. Called up value excluding premium till the date of forfeiture is only 10. So that is what consider here. So 100 into 10 comes to 1000. Securities premium 100 into 2, it comes to 200. Now what is credited here? Two share allotment. 100 into 4, it comes to 400. What is that? Unpaid. Out of what we have called him to pay, whatever he has not paid will be first credited, followed by whatever he has paid so far will be credited next. This is the idea. Fine. Two share allotment, 100 into 4, which he has not paid, is credited first. Two share call money, that is also not paid by the shareholder. So 100 into 4, it comes to 400. Two share forfeiture, that is the only amount he has paid, which is nothing but application money. So 100 into 4, it comes to 400. So whatever we called is debited, that capital is done separately, premium is done separately, and then whatever he has not paid, unpaid, that have been credited in this journal. This is a understanding over this particular journal entry for forfeiture. Then journal entry for reissue, bank account debtor, debit part comes in as per the rule of real account, money comes in, therefore it is debited. 50 into 8, it comes to 400. What is the loss on reissue? 2 rupees per share. The par value of the share is 10, issue price is 8, so 10 minus 8 gives you 2 rupees, that is a loss on reissue. So, share forfeiture account, debtor, 50 into 2, it comes to 100. 2 share capital account, which is nothing but 50 into 10, it comes to 500. Now, let's look at the final journal entry. Share forfeiture account debtor, here the remaining amount on the forfeiture account of reissued shares will be transferred to capital reserve. How many shares have been reissued? It's only 50. Please understand that. I will explain the working down there again. Share forfeiture account debtor, 50 shares into 2 rupees. The loss on reissue is subtracted out of the 4 rupees of the forfeiture amount, and the balance 2 rupees is a remaining amount per share of reissued shares. So therefore that amount is transferred. So 50 into 2, it comes to 100. See, forfeiture amount per share available was 4 rupees. Loss on reissue per share is 2 rupees. So 4 minus 2 will give you the remaining 2, and that figure is transferred to capital reserve account. So 50 into 2, 100 is transferred to capital reserve. Please have a look at this particular working. This working has been customized by me. Calculation of amount to be transferred to capital reserve. Share forfeiture account, 400 was available on all the 400 shares forfeited. 100 into 4, it comes to 400. Now reissued shares are given in the left side of the table. Non-reissued shares are given in the right side of the table. Let's look at, you know, this particular part first. Reissued shares 50. Share forfeiture account for the reissued shares 50 into 4, it comes to 200. And from this 200 rupees, let us subtract the loss on reissue of the 50 shares. 50 into 2, you deduct 100. And the remaining goes to capital reserve, 100. What about the non-reissued shares? This share forfeiture account has to be remain and maintain till they are reissued. So share forfeiture account for the 50 shares which are left with the company, 50 into 4, it comes to 200. And that will be there as it is, and it will be taken over to balance sheet and written under capital and reserves. Once they are reissued in the future, the remaining amount in the forfeiture account of those shares will also be transferred to capital reserve. This is what the understanding over partial reissue of forfeited shares. Thanks for watching this video. If you like this video, you subscribe my channel so that I will be encouraged to release more and more of accounting videos and marketing videos as well. Thanks for watching.